Attorney Laura Anthony, founding partner of Legal and Compliance, a full-service corporate securities and business transactions law firm. Today is the continuation in a LawCast series talking about distributed ledger technology, often called DLT, or blockchain. Currently, market participants are experimenting with several uses of DLT within the market infrastructure and ecosystem. DLT can be used in specific markets, such as debt, equity, and derivatives, and specific market functions, such as clearing. Many discrete applications exist for the use of DLT, including, for example, clearing arrangements, record-keeping requirements, and trade and order reporting and processing. In addition, DLT can impact financial condition record-keeping and reporting, verification of assets, anti-money laundering, know your customer, supervision and surveillance, fees and commissions, payments to unregistered persons, customer confirmations, materiality impact on business operations, business continuity plans, and almost all aspects of the market system and broker-dealers within those market systems. The most common current use of DLT is related to private company equities. DLT can be used to track transfers, maintain shareholder records, and for capitalization tables. Nasdaq has utilized DLT technology to complete and record a private securities transaction using its Nasdaq Linq blockchain ledger technology. The Nasdaq platform allows private companies to use DLT to record and track the trading of private securities. DLT will eventually be used for public company equities, but the regulatory aspects are behind the technology. However, Overstock's Patrick Byrne has created and launched a private platform to allow for public trading of securities using blockchain, and his platform is called TO Technologies. The platform only currently trades Overstock's digital shares, but as an SEC-licensed alternative trading system, or ATS, the foundation is in place for utilizing the platform to launch and trade public offerings for third-party securities. The debt market also sees the benefit of DLT. The current average settlement time for the secondary trading of syndicated loans is approximately 1 month. The repurchase agreement marketplace is filled with inefficiencies, as is the trading markets for corporate bonds. DLT could be used in all aspects of these markets. It is thought that DLT can also be used to automate the derivative marketplace and create greater transparency. DLT technology is being worked on to create operational processes within the securities industry itself, as well as and including by creating central repositories for standardized reference data for various securities products, creating efficiencies for all market participants. DLT can also centralize identity management functions on a global scale. I'm securities attorney Laura Anthony, founding partner of Legal and Compliance and producer of LawCast. Should you have any questions about today's topic, please visit securitieslawblog.com and lawcast.com, or contact me directly. Inquiries of a technical nature are always encouraged.